Good afternoon. Thanks very much for having me here. My name is Taina Gibo. I'm a head of strategic insights at a company called Portland Design. We are a London-based multidisciplinary design agency specializing in retail design, FMB, master planning, ensuring that our clients, businesses, airport operators, and retailers and brands are fit for the 21st century, the challenges that we're facing as retailers and brands and marketeers. We essentially are about utilizing a number of different skill sets. We have designers, architects, we have brand specialists, and really our whole purpose is to ensure that we create future-ready design solutions, whether that's for F&B operators, whether it's for brands, whether it's for the array of different retailers that we work with. And at Portland, we design future-proofed shopping. We seek inspiration in trends. We imagine the impacts of innovations, and our solutions are guided by informed intuition. We bring innovation from the breadth of the depth of our experience of working across categories and continents. We also have a very unique insight methodology. We think it's essential to understand the interplay between people, places, products, and platforms in the 21st century. These things are totally interconnected. So it's about understanding how do consumers come to the decisions in terms of where to shop? What are those type of retail destinations that they choose, whether it's physical, online, or on the high street? How are consumers able to make decisions across the vast array of product choices that are available to them? And equally, you know, we probe those multiple digital and physical touch points the consumers are having to deal with. So that's kind of Portland in the way. I want to start today by talking about the fact that we're living in a very super VUCA world. This is a term from the military, which I think is quite appropriate to the times we're living in. So VUCA stands for volatile, uncertain, complex, and ambiguous. And I think politically, socially, economically, we are seeing a lot of this happening, whether it's from Donald Trump, where it's my fellow citizens choosing to leave Europe. I didn't vote for that myself. Or what we're experiencing potentially in Italy and the election coming up in France. You know, so this is an unknown time we've been living in. And I think this is particularly relevant to the world of retail. We are living in a time when retail is experiencing huge upheaval, massive complexities, and disruption. According to the Harvard Business Review, they say that every 50 years, retail undergoes a massive wave of disruption and innovation. So today, that's what I want to talk about. I want to talk about the shift that's happening in new consumer expectations from a new generation of consumers who have very different expectations and desires and demands from you as brands and retailers. So this is from KPMG. They say, today's consumers are demanding convenience, value, and amazing experience. And it's these three key trends that are driving disruption to existing markets and business models on an unprecedented scale. And I want to put that in context, because I think as brands, as retailers and marketers, we need to start to prepare for a new future, a new generation of consumers, Generation Z. So by 2020, Generation Z, these are today's 14 to 19-year-olds, will be the largest group of consumers worldwide, making up to 40% of the US, Europe, and BRIC countries, and 10% in the rest of the world. And by then, they will be and constitute the largest group of consumers worldwide. So it's imperative that we start to understand these consumers and what their needs and desires are. So who are Gen Z? Well, they can be described as a post-millennial teenagers who have grown up with very different values, attitudes, and consumer behaviors. And this is Ernst & Young, and they say about Gen Z that politically, socially, technologically, and economically, we are moving at warp speed. These changes have created a generation very different than any known before. Retailers, and in fact, all businesses hoping to connect with these savvy consumers need to understand who they are, what they want, and how they want it. So, they live in the moment with an eye towards the future, but 63% of global Gen Z consumers are incredibly worried about the future. And it's not surprising. This is a generation that has grown up, yes, with ubiquitous connectivity. You know, they're the digital first generation. They've grown up in a post-internet world where the likes of e-commerce and mobile commerce is completely natural and familiar with them. But equally, they've also grown up with 9/11, terrorism, economic disasters. So it's not surprising this generation just looks at the world in a very, very, very different way. So Gen Z is twice as likely to shop on a mobile than millennial consumers. Equally, we talk about the experience economy, and this generation of Gen Z consumers are very much embracing that. So 72% of Gen Z and 78% of millennials would rather pay money for an experience over a product. So that's quite profound. As marketeers, as brands, as retailers, this is your future consumers who generally are looking more for leisure, eating out, and convivial experiences as opposed to owning things. And then you can put that in context. So this is from insight from the True Youth Monitor. And they said, very much in the past, teenagers used fashion brands and, as a kind of, you know, a symbol to demonstrate who they were and a kind of status. This generation is very different. They're far more self-assured. And so the percentage of adults who agreed with the statement, I care a lot about whether my clothes are in style, dropped from 65% in 1997 to 47% into 2014. Equally, what we're starting to see is, you know, a shift away from wanting to own stuff. So from 2005 to spring 2016, of the total amount spent by teenagers on key fashion categories of clothing, accessories, and footwear has fallen from 45% to 38%. So equally, we start to see that they're choosing less to spend that disposable income on the goods that would traditionally was the heartline of teenager brands, sneakers, jeans, etc. So I think we have a lot to learn from this generation, a lot to gain, because, you know, it's about understanding and learning what drives them now. We can begin to predict not only how they will behave in the future, but also how to be ready to engage them when we get there too. I think it's you know, we hear constantly across, you know, research about the fact that this is a generation that loves purchasing online, they love mobiles, super digitally connected, et cetera, et cetera. But the one thing we need to come back to again and again, right, and this is seen universally in numbers of research studies, is the fact that this generation of consumers, they still like shopping in brick-and-mortar stores, you know? But what they do want, they want a hyper-convenient, stress-free environment. They don't see a differentiator between online or offline. They want a seamless, integrated shopping experience. And I think I love this quote. This is from Rachel Streckman, who's a founder and CEO of Story in New York, a very interesting retail model that changes every month. It's a combination of a magazine and a gallery and a shop. And she said, if time is the ultimate luxury and people want a higher return of investment of their time, you need to give them a reason to be in a physical space. And I think that kind of crystallizes the challenge facing retailers and brands in the 21st century. What is my purpose to going and visiting a store when I can experience and purchase everything from the comfort of my home? As we've seen with Black Friday, you know, again, breaking records. People aren't choosing to go and purchase in stores. They're doing it from their home. So what would make me go to a store? It feels in the 21st century, as a retailer, it's about reimagining the retail experience for a digital world, you know? The likes of Nike, the likes of Sephora, the likes of Apple, they're investing massive millions of dollars in dedicated retail offerings. So the new Nike Soho store in New York is profoundly changing the world of sports retailing. So it has basketball courts, it has trained, dedicated athletes as sales associates. It is creating this convivial experience to go and, you know, experience the best that Nike can offer in terms of products, but also in terms of experiences within that store. Equally, the likes of Apple is completely redesigning its stores at the moment to not just be a transactional point of view, but also about creating more community involvement in terms of how those stores are designed, how open they are, how transparent they are. You know, not just about trying to make money, but also about kind of giving you a heightened experience. And equally, Sephora has been really at the heart in terms of really embracing innovation, really embracing game-changing technology to redesign what the idea of beauty is. So I think in the future, the winners will be the retailers and brands who can identify and understand Gen Z's needs and align not only their digital and in-store experiences with their behaviors. So this generation are very much, you know, they live and breathe through digital touch points. You know, the mobile phone is very much at them. So what we're starting to see, what we're seeing is innovative brands harnessing this. So this is about creating personalized loyalty schemes using app technology to understand preferences, to understand shopping behaviors, and actually tailoring content and pushing that out to you individually. It's highly personalized, you know, from the likes of people like Gap. Equally, it's about, we've heard a lot about the world of artificial intelligence, you know, and chatbot commerce. 2017, we're going to see more of this. This is only going to grow and grow and grow. So the idea being a lot of these companies like North Face and Macy's integrating IBM Watson technology. So this is essentially computers learning to have conversations with consumers, asking what it is you want. How are you going to use that jacket or that item? So for example, North Face, I think they trialed 50,000 people in the US. The average conversation with the chatbot was 2 minutes, and it led to, I think, a 66% conversion click-through rate. So equally, technology is there, and it's been harnessed, but it's also working. So we start to see the likes of Aldo creating smart tech services, which is about utilizing the best of technology to create better services, to really kind of understand me as a consumer. We talk a lot about connected fitting rooms, but I think the likes of Shop With Me, Polo, are equally kind of at the forefront of creating something that's quite kind of interesting and very kind of actionable. So Shop With Me enables consumers to go into a store, use a mobile phone to click on RFID clothes tagged with RFID tags. You go into your dressing room, and you're then able to configure your mobile with the fitting room mirror, and you can have an edit, and then a sales associate will bring those products to you into the fitting room. Equally, you know, I think what we're going to start seeing more and more of is the idea of how do we start to merge the physical and the virtual. And increasingly, you know, the likes of Sephora, we talked about previously, are very much at the forefront in enabling consumers to have that experience. You know, and with the proliferation of VR headsets becoming more and more customers, I think there's a huge opportunity for brands to kind of harness this as we move forward. We know this generation are passionate about personalizing their products. They want customized products. They don't want an off-the-shelf solution. So we see Converse, we see Levi's, we see even the likes of Polo Ralph Lauren creating customization bars. I can buy a product, but then I can personalize it to my own liking in-store. But it doesn't end there, because this generation want hyper-convenient solutions. So it's not just necessarily about what do I do online, what do I do in-store. It's about enabling me to actually, how do I deliver these products that I bought in a really seamless, convenient, easy way. So particularly in the UK, we see a lot of new startups, Doodle and Dropit, creating app-based solutions. So Dropit, you pay a fee, you go shopping, and then you drop your bags at a particular spot, and then they will deliver them back to your home. So again, it's all about creating this idea of value, convenience, and experience, all completely integrated. And equally, what we start to see is the idea of kind of immersive, interesting pop-ups. We know that pop-ups are hugely successful at this generation, but Nike created a pop-up experience for sneakerheads. It was invite only. You needed an app to get in there. They created this kind of, you know, massive experiential store that looked like a sneaker box. So again, it's about kind of taking all the lessons and all the learnings, but trying to create an experience that is really, really tailored to this generation. And equally, what we're starting to see a lot of brands doing is, you know, this generation are very keen on understanding the kind of story behind a brand. They're very keen in terms of the you know, environmental credentials, in terms of how you source materials, about how you treat your staff. You know, how is a product sourced right through to being brought into store. So we see Everlane now know your factories, you know, revealing the design process, enabling consumers to come into those factories and actually see how those products are made. So equally, it's about a brand building exercise and being very transparent and actually showing the kind of mechanics of how you produce goods. Equally, with the rise of AI and chatbot commerce, what we're going to see 2017 and onwards is the idea that social commerce will start to become more prominent. You know, it's the next defining kind of transformational thing that's going to happen. The ability to be on Snapchat or one of those Instagram or the array of social media platforms that exist and be able to simply click and purchase a product. This is all expected. This is all going to happen. So, okay, How can you as retailers and brands embrace this next wave of disruption, innovation, and game-changing technology to create a retail ecosystem that is fit for future shoppers like Generation Z? This is a chart from Accenture, which really points to the future of Industry 4.4. We're on the cusp of a fourth industrial revolution that's going to revolutionize the world that we live in. You know, it's going to make some of us redundant, because actually robots will replace some of the jobs that we're taking. But equally, as you know, any vertical, whether it's fashion or e-commerce or you know, automotive, this is the future. How can you start to integrate mobile devices and cloud computing and IoT and 3D printing? This is all it's at. How can you be able to harness data to create more tailored, responsive, personalized experiences? So this is going to happen. This is where we're heading for the 21st century. But equally, I think what's the really crucial thing that we need to bear in mind of is the fact that, and I love this quote, I think this totally kind of encapsulates the challenge facing everyone. This is from Sapient Natro, a digital agency. And they say, retailing in the digital age doesn't mean introducing digital to the physical space. Instead, it means redefining your entire business around operating in a digital world. So, you know, it's not necessarily about inputting mirrors and technology that ends up breaking down, but it's really about taking a whole 360-degree view in terms of how you start to align your business to a digital world. So, moving forward, what do you do? Well, stores need to transform. Remember the quote about you need to give a reason for consumers to visit a physical space. It's about in-store innovation and retailtainment. You know, stores are going to evolve to become retail theaters, immersive, experience-based areas that showcase products and the creative process in a really kind of intuitive and creative way. It's about augmenting the brand experience. So this is the Samsung store in New York, which doesn't sell any products. All it is a huge multi-layered theater, which is about essentially experiencing what it's like to be Samsung and to enjoy those products. And this is where it's heading. This is what the future is about. It's about total channel convergence. This generation doesn't see a difference between offline and online. They want a seamless, integrated solution that works across all those channels. So it's about ensuring that whether it's mobile or online or physical stores are totally integrated across all those customer shopping points. It's equally about creating personal and intimate and dynamic connections. You know, as a consumer, I want you to create personalized product recommendations for you. I want you to create offers and recommendations that's tailored to my needs and my expectations because you know my preferences. You've got the data. You know who I am as a consumer, so I want a tailored experience, whether it's about pricing or collection or delivery. And it's about in-the-moment personalization. You know, it's about using kind of context-aware technology, using data and analytics to personalize that interaction in-store, whether that's through products, whether it's about the pricing, whether it's about the actual kind of enabling me to customize those products in-store. So ultimately, we are heading to a point where a store is going to have to evolve to become a hub of interactive experiences, reimagined to be an immersive space that really is about capturing and amplifying the emotions of what your brand stands for, to really enhance and create, you know, a real kind of synergy between you and your consumers. At Portland, we have something called our Omni Experience Wheel. And really, what we're trying to say to clients when they come to speak to us is about, in the 21st century, you've got to have total integration between all those touch points. Whether it's about web or virtual or physical or online or mobile or sales staff or stories, you know, it really has to start and be kind of integrated. You can't do these things in isolation. You really have to ensure that that your entire business, from fulfillment right through to stores, are completely integrated. And with the start of, you know, the industrial fourth revolution, then this is essentially you know, what the future will be about. So to conclude, retailing the connected world. It's about, you know, next generations must enable customers to interact and engage with their business seamlessly across whatever channel and device they want. It's not about physical stores versus online. It's about creating an integrating retail ecosystem and a true omni-channel strategy. It's about empowering your retail staff to deliver a greater, more customized service to improve that in-store experience when you go in, you know, through knowledge and training, and then enabling them to be as experts about your products and your offering as your consumers are. It's equally about seizing the opportunity to disrupt and innovate and to integrate technology that's relevant to what your offering is, to what your retail offering is and what your brand is, to meet those needs. You know, it's about helping you to kind of future-proof, to enable you to ensure that you are fit for purpose for the 21st century. And it's ultimately about delivering a personalized experience for the customer that gives them that added value, but equally will generate loyalty. Thank you for your time.